Josh, you're probably wondering, what does this mean for your little athlete? Is it really safe to let them suit up? And what kind of impact could head injuries have on the rest of their lives? News 6's Karen Johnson is live tonight in the newsroom with more on this story. Karen?
Well, Sheree, doctors say right now they know very little about how head injuries affect children long term. They say they're still in their early stages of research, but what they are finding, head injuries seem to be more damaging to kids' brains than adults.
Keb Wright shopping today for new football helmets for his two sons.
I had planned on it anyhow, but obviously with the revelation about Chris Henry and the injuries that they're finding with National Football League players with head injuries, I certainly want to do what I can to help protect them.
So he's splurging on the $300 helmet, one with a shock absorber in the mask. Greg Cook, owner of Cook Sporting Goods, says the one Bright chose is the most protective helmet in the industry. But what's more important to preventing injury is that it fits properly.
You need to have the helmet touching the surface areas of the head so that when the shock is dispersed, it is dispersed to all areas.
Sports medicine doctors say concussions to a child's developing brain seem to be more damaging than ones to adult brains. And repeated blows to the head in kids can lead to degenerative brain syndromes.
If your child has had one concussion prior and you're putting them out there for a second or third or fourth concussion, you're asking for bad things to happen.
And Dr. Hewitt says when it comes to football, parents and coaches should be teaching kids not to ram with their heads. But he says, as seen in the past, that probably won't change until the rules do. Sheree.